New discovery challenges Planet 9. Mysterious new world discovered in the outer reaches of our solar system challenges Planet 9 theory. Astronomers have uncovered a fascinating celestial object orbiting in the farthest regions of our solar system, a discovery that could reshape our understanding of the outer solar system and challenge existing theories about potential ninth planet. Join us as we take a deep dive into this story on the AI podcast.
Welcome to the deep dive. Today we're heading way, way out. Think the absolute edges of our solar system, far beyond Pluto. There's been a new discovery out there, an icy world.
That's right. And what we want to do today is unpack this discovery, this object they're calling ammonite.
Yeah, because its orbit is, well, it's pretty strange. And it's making waves, challenging a really big idea in astronomy.
Exactly. The theory of Planet 9, a theory many people have, you know, put a lot of stock into.
So for this deep dive, we're pulling from the latest research, right? Reports covering the fossil survey's findings.
Yep, things like the paper ammonite, icy world challenges Planet 9 theory. It's not just, look, another object. This could genuinely shift how we view the outer solar system.
Okay, let's start with the discovery itself. What is this? Ammonite. Its official name is 2023 KQ14, I think.
That's the one. Discovered using the Subaru telescope in Hawaii. It's small, icy, and incredibly far out, just tucked away in the most remote part of our solar system we can currently observe.
And what makes it stand out? I mean, we find objects out there occasionally.
Well, it's what kind of object it is. It's a sednoid. And those are super rare.
Sednoid. Okay, remind us what that means.
Basically, they're these icy bodies with really, really elongated orbits, way beyond the Kuiper Belt. We've only ever confirmed maybe four others before ammonite.
Only four. Wow. Okay, so finding another one is a big deal.
A very big deal. Like finding a specific type of fossil, you know, extremely rare.
And the orbit itself, you said it was strange.
It's staggering, really. It orbits about 71 times further from the sun than Earth does. 71 AU.
71 times. It's hard to even picture.
It is. But here's the kicker. That orbit, as stretched out as it is, seems to have been stable for almost the entire history of the solar system, like 4.5 billion years.
Whoa! How does something maintain an orbit like that for so long? It's like it's frozen in time.
Exactly. That's why the nickname ammonite is so fitting. It's like a cosmic fossil preserving conditions from the early solar system.
And it wasn't just a lucky find, was it? It came from a specific project.
Correct. Part of the Fossil Survey, F-O-S-S-I-L, stands for Formation of the Outer Solar System. An icy legacy.
Okay, so they're actively looking for these ancient remnants.
Precisely. The whole point is to find these old objects because they hold clues about how the solar system formed and evolved. Things Neptune's gravity hasn't messed with too much.
Right. And one of the scientists involved, Fumi Yoshida, said something about this, didn't she?
She did. She basically said, finding objects like this with these really stretched orbits and large perihelion distances, meaning they stay far from the sun, even at their closest point, implies something extraordinary happened back when ammonite formed.
Something extraordinary. Okay, and for a long time, the main theory explaining these kinds of extraordinary orbits and other weird things out there was Planet 9.
That's been the leading hypothesis, yeah. Uh-huh. Also called Planet X sometimes. This idea of a huge hidden planet way out past Neptune, maybe 5 to 10 times the mass of Earth.
Lurking in the dark, essentially.
Pretty much. Unseen, but its gravity would supposedly explain a lot of weird stuff.
Like what were the big clues pointing towards this hypothetical planet?
Well, a couple of key things. First, the Kuiper Belt itself, it's tilted.
The whole belt of icy objects.
Yeah, the main plane of it is tilted by about 20 degrees relative to the plane where Earth and the other major planets orbit.
Mm.
That's odd. It needs an explanation.
Okay, a tilted Kuiper Belt. What else?
Then there's the clustering. You see these groups of really distant dwarf planets and other icy bodies, and their orbits seem weirdly aligned, like they're all pointing in roughly the same direction, moving in sync almost.
As if something big is sort of hurting them,
yeah,
gravitationally.
That's the idea. Planet 9's gravity would be the shepherd, keeping them clustered.
And didn't NASA suggest Planet 9 would make our solar system look more average?
Yeah, that was an interesting point they made. Many other star systems we see have super Earths, planets bigger than Earth, smaller than Neptune. We don't seem to have one of those. Unless Planet 9 is it.
So it kind of filled a gap in our planetary lineup, theoretically.
Right. It tidied things up, made us look less peculiar compared to other systems.
Okay, so Planet 9 sounds like a neat explanation for a lot of anomalies, but now, here comes ammonite.
Here comes ammonite, And it complicates the picture significantly.
How so? What specifically about its orbit messes with the Planet Nine theory?
Well, what's weird is that for billions of years, its orbit probably did look like the others that seemed to point to Planet Nine.
Yeah.
But its current path, especially its perihelion, its closest point to the sun, it's just different. It's much further out than the models predicting Planet Nine's influence would suggest for an object like this. It doesn't fit the neat clustering pattern.
So it's an outlier, even among the outliers.
In a way, yes. It suggests the gravitational environment out there is, well, maybe not as simple as just one big planet pulling the strings. Or at least not in the way we thought.
Okay, so if Ammonite doesn't quite fit the Planet Nine model, what else could explain these weird, stretched-out orbits?
This is where a really interesting alternative comes up, proposed by the Japanese research team that found Ammonite. Dr. Yukun Wang was part of this.
And their idea is?
They suggested.
Okay.
What if there was a big planet out there once, but it got ejected? Thrown out of the solar system entirely.
Ejecta, like flung out into interstellar space.
Exactly. The idea is that maybe a planet did form out there or migrated out there, sculpted these orbits we see.
Yeah.
And then got kicked out due to gravitational interactions, maybe with Jupiter or Saturn or even another unseen body billions of years ago.
Wow. So the architect of these orbits might not even be in the solar system anymore.
That's the possibility they raised. It could explain why Ammonite's current orbit doesn't quite match the models based on a Planet Nine that's still there. The influence that shaped it is gone.
That's a fundamentally different picture.
It is.
Well,
and it also implies that if Planet Nine does still exist, maybe Ammonite's orbit suggests it has to be even further away than we thought.
Further away, like too far to have the effects we thought it did.
Potentially. So far away that its gravitational pull wouldn't be strong enough to create that neat clustering or the Kuiper belt tilt we observe.
Mm.
Or perhaps its effects are just different than our current models predict.
So Ammonite isn't necessarily disproving Planet Nine outright, but it's definitely challenging the current versions of the theory.
It's posing a significant challenge, yes. It's forcing us to rethink. Was there a planet that got ejected? Or is Planet Nine much further out, or maybe just different than we assumed?
Mm-hmm.
Or is something else going on entirely?
It really opens up the possibility, suggests the outer solar system's history might be more dynamic, maybe even more violent than we pictured.
Absolutely. Planets getting kicked out. Mm. That's dramatic stuff. It makes you reconsider the whole evolution of our system.
So even though it complicates things for Planet Nine hunters, Ammonite itself is still incredibly valuable, right?
Oh, immensely valuable. Finding any sedenoid is huge. Its composition being so icy and presumably unchanged.
Mm-hmm.
Its unique orbit, stable yet divergent. Its distance, keeping it relatively free from Neptune's later influence. It's a treasure trove.
A direct link to the solar system's baby pictures, almost.
That's a great way to put it. It holds clues we can't easily get elsewhere about those first few hundred million years.
And the fossil survey team hopes to find more of these.
That's the goal. Fumi Yoshida expressed that hope, saying they want to find many more discoveries like Ammonite to draw a complete picture of the history of the solar system.
Makes sense. Each one is a piece of a giant ancient puzzle.
Exactly. And the more pieces we find, even the ones that don't seem to fit at first, the clearer that overall picture eventually becomes.
Okay, so let's just quickly recap for everyone listening. We have this tiny new icy world, Ammonite, way out beyond Pluto.
Discovered by the Fossil Survey, a super rare type of object called a sedenoid.
And its orbit, while ancient and stable, has this weird quirk that doesn't quite line up with the prevailing theory of a hidden Planet Nine.
Right. It's challenged that theory, making scientists consider alternatives, like maybe a planet being ejected from the solar system long ago.
Mm. So this little object is pushing us to rethink the entire story of our outer solar system. Amazing.
It really shows how one discovery can ripple outwards and change our perspective. Science in action.
Which leaves us with a pretty cool thought to ponder, doesn't it? What if our solar system's past isn't just about the planets we see now, but about lost giants?
Planets that shaped things early on, maybe set orbits like Ammonites in motion, and then we're just gone, ejected into the void.
Makes you wonder, what other hidden histories, what other cosmic fossils or evidence of lost worlds are still waiting out there in the dark for us to find?
Okay, one question for you. If a giant planet really was ejected from the solar system, where could it be now? Don't forget to comment it. Thanks.